Ascent Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Strategy Book, How to Think and Act Strategically to Deliver Outstanding Results, 3rd edition, by Max Mckeown. Narrated by Jonathan Johns. Publisher's note: this audiobook contains references to material present in the print and ebook editions of the book. Strategy is about shaping the future. Smart strategy is the best way to desirable ends with available means. All can see the tactics whereby I conquer, but none can see the strategy out of which victory is evolved. Sun Tzu. First words. Strategy is about moving from where you are to where you want to be. Smart strategy is the shortest route to desirable ends with available means. Strategy is as much about deciding what to do, where to go, why, when, and how, as about choosing what not to do. Yes, no, what if, why not? Planning backwards from a better future. This book is about strategy in action. It's about making strategic principles and cutting-edge research useful. The third edition includes even more real-world examples of strategy in action. You will also find more on new ideas in strategy, sustainability, tensions, psychology, behavioral strategy, and how to combine creativity and entrepreneurship. You will also find 3 new tools to help you make strategy useful. First, a model sets out the big 5 strategy question. Second, at the start of the toolkit, a powerful tool for creating smart strategy that is practical and fast. Third, a big picture model that brings strategy, culture, and innovation together. Strategy, particularly competitive strategy, is not once and done. It is continual, it is creative, it is adaptive. The updated examples emphasize how past strategic success, however impressive, does not guarantee further success without successful strategic adaptation. Our human world is the result of individual strategies, our desires and actions, dreams and ideas. Strategists are able to see the past, present and future as connected. You can link your actions with the actions of those around you, and you will be able to shape events by reacting intelligently and spontaneously to them. Dr. Max Mckeown. Introduction. What can the strategy book do for you? This book can help you understand strategy. You can use the secrets in this book to become an effective strategic thinker and leader. If you are ambitious, you can use the powerful strategy tools in this book to shape your future. The strategy book has its own strategic advantage. It is easy to consume without dumbing down its strategic ideas. It is simple to use, but is still based on a core set of intelligent strategic foundations. It offers clear explanations of tools that will help you make sense of complex leadership situations. The strategy book is based on hard-won experience and knowledge. I've worked with some of the most admired companies in the world. I've also worked with smaller companies who are some of the most ambitious companies in the world. Some were feeling complacent, others were facing problems and crisis points. All of them wanted more success. The strategy book helps with all of those situations, and it also helps people who are studying strategy as part of a course or degree. A lot of the books you have to study are either too shallow or far too long. This book is about giving you the best ideas in strategy, but wrapped up in a usable, enjoyable package. How to use this book? The strategy book is organized into 6 parts. The first 5 parts tackle the really important challenges that a leader of any team of any size will face in creating strategy and making that strategy work. Each part is subdivided into specific action topics. You can dip in and out of each section as you feel relevant. They have been written clearly, so that you can benefit from my experience as a strategist, whether you are a novice or an expert. Each of the action topics has the following structure: headline description, so you know what the topic is about and why it's important. Strategic examples, so you can hear about a successful company or person that faced the same kind of challenge and principles to succeed. objective, why you should take the subject seriously as a leader, and what you should be trying to achieve, context, how the subject fits into the broader pattern of leadership, and the kind of situation you are dealing with to achieve success. Challenge, why the subject is difficult and valuable, and also ways of succeeding with the challenge effectively as a strategist. Success, what has to happen to succeed with the challenge? Strategists, measures of success. Ways you can assess your progress. Strategists, checklist. A summary of the actions you have to take to put the strategy principle into action. Related ideas. Some suggestions of other writers' ideas that support or complement the strategic topic. The sixth part is the strategist toolkit. The most important models and tools of strategy are explained in very precise, practical, and efficient terms. Here you will find the big five strategy questions, the quick strategy canvas, and the big strategic picture. You can move from the toolkit to the action topics, or you can move from specific action topics back to models that help you to organize your thoughts. There is also a list of further reading in the print and ebook versions of the book, if you want to dig deeper. And naturally, there is an index to make it easier to find your way to specific topics. The strategy book is clearly structured and easy to use, something that you will find yourself referring back to again and again. Strategy is about shaping the future. Strategy is the best route to desirable ends with available means. What is strategy? Strategy is about shaping the future. It is about how people attain desirable ends with available means. That's the reason we're interested. And that's the best definition I can offer you. But as a strategist, it can also help to understand some of the different arguments about what strategy is and isn't. You don't have to know the whole history. You don't have to get a doctorate or an MBA, but it's helpful to be informed. Frequency. Read first, review occasionally. Key participants. First you, then everyone. Google made the decision to give its engineers permission to experiment in free time. They used this free time to produce an online video service. This experiment taught executives the importance of online video, so they bought YouTube as a priority when it became popular. As a result, they still have two of the most popular search services in the world. Not really a plan, yet all about opportunity. Was this creative strategy at work? Objective. There are some benefits to understanding the history of strategy as it's usually told in business schools and textbooks. It helps you to discuss strategy knowledgeably and to see its limitations as well as its purpose. Ancient strategy. The word strategy has its origins in the Greek word strategos, which means general or someone who has an army. Stratos, to lead. It was first used in Athens, 508 BC, to describe the art of leadership used by the 10 generals on the war council. They developed principles of effective leadership and achieving objectives. This included approaches to war and motivating soldiers. Similar concepts about strategy emerged in Asia, most famously in Sun Tzu's Art of War, written 200 BC, which is still bought by people today. In his book, Sun Tzu lists different principles that leaders may follow to win and achieve their goals. It set a pattern for books about strategy that is still followed. Experienced executives and consultants share their experience of planning for success. Corporate strategy started getting a lot of attention from the 1950s. It was only after the Second World War that strategy books appeared for business leaders. Alfred Chandler, who was a historian who, in the 1960s, examined the relationship between strategy and organizational structure. He concluded that the strategy chosen by the company will lead to changes in the structure of the company. His work also shows that strategy was not a new concept in business, since it was based on what companies were already doing. Igor Ansov was a manager and mathematician often described as the father of strategic management. His book, Corporate Strategy, was published in 1965 and was a comprehensive attempt to explain how managers could plan for a more successful future. Ansoff was the most prominent writer of an approach to strategy that became obsessed with detailed planning. It was a perfect fit for a management style that was all about control. It led to a view that CEOs could work with strategic planning teams to analyze the past to predict the future. Early computers were used to help crunch the numbers and print the plans used to issue orders to real people in middle management and the front lines. Henry Mintzberg is a Canadian professor and contrarian who mocked planning obsession. He argued that only some strategic plans ever happened the way they were intended. The big picture, or strategy, was decided by a stream of individual actions. He believed that most strategy emerges from adaptation. Arguments between planning and learning approaches continue today. Michael Porter, also a professor, continued the mathematical approach to strategy. For him, strategy was about detailed analysis with clear models. These models were designed to determine what position the company should take in relation to other competitors in the market. Context. In some ways, the intellectual history of strategy is more complex than my short introduction. Yet in other ways, it's simpler. Some argue for the more creative human side, while others argue for the more analytical side of strategy. Both are important. So a strategist asks, what balance of these approaches is most helpful in any particular situation? What are you doing at the moment? How does that compare to your competitors? What do you want to achieve? How can you create something people want? The first two questions are analytical. They are about positioning and benchmarking. The second set of questions are creative and are about desire and contribution. They are interrelated, but the balance between them varies. The balance depends on your personal preferences and circumstances. Challenge. If your market is stable and you're happy with your situation, then you may choose to keep planning and adapting in a predictable way. But if your market is dynamic and you want your situation to change, then you may choose to inject more creativity into improving what you offer and achieve. This book includes tools for both analytical and creative strategy. It also includes my opinion that creative, dynamic strategy is the more helpful approach to take. The analytical tools can be used creatively to contribute something worthwhile and, if you wish, difficult to copy. Success. You'll know that you understand the principle when you see the difference between creative and analytical approaches to strategy. You will also be able to combine the tools and the principles throughout this book to think like a strategist about the bigger picture and what you want to contribute. You can study everything from ideas about how to run a strategy meeting to why reacting is more important than planning, to specific strategies that you can choose to use or adapt. The overall aim is to improve your ability to do something worthwhile, something better than merely sustaining competitive edge. Strategists, measures of success. The basic origins of modern corporate strategy are understood. The difference between creative and analytical strategy is recognized. Creative and analytical tools and principles are used together. Stable and dynamic markets are treated differently. You know there is more to strategy than beating or copying your competitors. Pitfalls. Over-reliance on any particular approach to strategy is dangerous. You are missing the big picture if you believe that you can ignore analysis, creativity, or the action that makes creativity and analysis come to life. Your organization may have a traditional approach to strategy. You will have to look carefully at how well the approach is working and what improvements can be made. Strategists' checklist. Consider the differences between analytical and creative strategy. Think about whether your company takes a more analytical or more creative approach. Explore whether the traditional approach is well suited to the environment you are facing. Keep referring back to the basic distinction as you proceed through the book, so you don't forget that all tools can be used in both ways. Introduce both analytical and creative approaches to your team. Discuss how they have been used in the past and how you could alter the balance in the future. Related ideas. Richard Whittington argues that strategy is hard, If strategy was easy, every company would succeed, but they don't. The important part is to learn how to think better and think differently. He introduces four schools of strategy. Classical, which seeks to maximize profit with deliberate processes. Evolutionary, which seeks to maximize profit with emergent processes. Systematic, which seeks plural objectives with deliberate processes. And processual, which has plural objectives with emergent processes. Regardless of which approach you take, John McGee, professor at Warwick Business School, argues that strategic decisions often have certain characteristics. Such decisions will involve risk because you are better on a future that is uncertain and complex, with preparations that are also uncertain and complex. Some strategic preparations require considerable time, effort, and even pain before any long-term benefit comes your way. Yet smart strategists, as the next part will explain, know that because events may prove you wrong, reacting may be as important as planning. The real heart of strategy is the strategist. Becoming a strategist is about getting better at shaping events. Part 1. Your strategic self. Strategy is about shaping the future. And that's the reason for this book, to help you to use strategy to figure out what to do now to get what you really want later. This book can help make strategy work more often. There are strategy tools and processes that can help, but the real heart of strategy is the strategist. It's what you know, how you think, and how you get people to care enough about what you are doing to achieve your goals. It's also about setting in motion the sequence of events that will shape the future in a way that you like. The more you understand the people who make events happen and the connections between what they do and those events, the smarter you will be. You have already used strategy to get a lot of what you have. You got a job, or you got an education to get a job. You might have saved money for a holiday or home. Maybe you romanced your partner, wife, or husband. You did something in the past to try to get something better in the future. Becoming a strategic thinker, a strategist, is about getting better at shaping events. In the business world, you need to understand how strategy is usually done. You need to know how to create strategy that convinces others to support you, including your boss or shareholders. And you need to know how to make strategy deliver success in the real world. Strategy that works. There is no guarantee that the future will turn out the way you want. Just writing a plan does not mean that the plan will happen. The world is more complex than our ability to plan, but that's part of what an effective strategist learns to accept. You learn that reacting and responding to events is just as important as planning. Some business schools and consultancies have sold the promise that strategy can solve everything. In their hands, strategy has become a cult that believes in the magical power of a few models. They have been taken away from the art of strategy and left some non-MBAs wondering if there is any room for entrepreneurial instinct. Others have become cynical about strategy. They hear the word and disengage. They expect bad or boring things to come from any strategic planning process. They predict job cuts or mindless changes, or just expect meaningless waffle that means nothing in the real world. And there is some truth to this view. Yet we have been trying to shape our future for as long as we have been human. It is in our nature to interpret our experience to provide shortcuts for a better future. This is what strategy is about, and how it can be of value in the real world. To become an effective strategist, you need to start with yourself. Begin by understanding how one thing leads to another. Get yourself an education in the basics of strategy tools and models. Pay more attention to where you are, what's happening around you, and how trends create opportunities to get where you want to be. Shaping the future. Strategy is about shaping the future. Corporate strategy is about shaping the future for an organization. You use strategy to figure out how to achieve your purpose and ambitions. You move between where you want to go, ends, and what you need to do to get there, means. Great strategy is the quickest route from available means to desirable ends to shape your future. Frequency. Every problem, every opportunity. Key participants. The whole organization. The Cheesecake Factory has grown into a billion-dollar corporation. Its recipe for success is based on a small number of strategic ingredients. The founder created a unique concept with the broadest, deepest menu in casual dining, and the best cheesecake he could make. They spend $2,000 per employee just on training to make sure people deliver the best customer experience. They open new restaurants when they find wonderful new locations, rather than just because they have money to spend or bonuses to earn. They focus on improving taste, with quality homemade cooking, rather than reducing cost. In response to changing preferences, they introduced home delivery, a skinnier menu, and a supermarket product line to increase brand awareness. These are strategic decisions. They are not accidental, although they did not all come from planning. They are part of a strategic package. They shape the competitive environment. They stop copycats. And they shape the future in ways that are desirable and believable to customers, investors, managers, and employees. Objective. Shaping the future of an organization involves every part and every one. Strategy considers things inside and outside the organization that will make a difference to its success. The strategist also looks for opportunities and threats to the future of the organization. Ideally, these are explored with imagination, ambition, and a creative understanding of customers, products, and resources. To shape the future requires a combination of thinking, planning, and reacting to events that emerge along the way. These provide key strategy questions. What do we want to do? What do we think is possible? What do we need to do to achieve our goals? When should we react to new opportunities and adapt plans? What do we want to do? This establishes a sense of what is desirable. Organizations tend to have an overall purpose. Sometimes the purpose is very precise and deliberately agreed. Sometimes the purpose of the organization is very ambiguous. There may be many different opinions about what the organization is for and what it should do. These opinions may conflict and compete with each other. This is all of interest to the strategic thinker. What do we think is possible? This introduces some sense of practicality. You look at opportunities in the world contrasted with the resources that the organization either has or can obtain. But looking at opportunities can also expand a sense of what is possible beyond what has been done in the past. What do the achievements of others and trends in technology and consumer desires allow your company to do next? What do we need to do to achieve our goals? This includes the necessary strategic moves to achieve the overall goals of the organization. It includes the style of leadership, the structures and processes of the organization, and the projects, tasks, roles, products, and services that have been done to achieve organizational aspirations. Ideally, these actions work together in some more or less harmonious way, so that the sum of actions is greater than their parts. When should we react to new opportunities and adapt plans? Our views of the future are incomplete. When we write our plans or decide on an overall purpose, we don't really know what is going to happen next. Small and big events will happen that challenge the existing strategy. New opportunities will emerge that are bigger, better, or just different from those we thought of the first time. Context. Shaping the future depends on context. You can't control the waves of human desire and endeavor with strategy, but you can create strategy that surfs those human waves, contributing to them or benefiting from them. It follows that you need to understand the context for any attempt to create strategy. There are probably some low-competition, high-stability places in the world, but it is safer to assume that the external context your strategy will face will be high-competition, low-stability. So this book will make the same assumption and give advice on strategy that can be effective in such a world. Each section answers questions that are needed to create a strategy that can be used to shape the future. There are sections that explain how to create strategy, think like a strategist, win with strategy, make your strategy work, build a strategic organization, and troubleshoot your strategy whenever it stops working. Challenge. A lot of organizations still set in motion grand plans to a better future. The larger the organization, even now, the more likely it is that they have a strategic planning team who produce strategy documents as a result of lengthy financial analysis. This plan is then cascaded or passed down the hierarchy until it reaches middle management, at which point it often disappears. The front line may have to work in structures, processes, or role descriptions that were designed as part of the plan. This planning, command, and control approach often leads to out-of-date strategy and out-of-touch leaders. Some people argue it isn't even possible to plan because events are so unpredictable. They claim it is better to just organize as efficiently as possible. Then you just hope evolutionary market forces, what people want interacting with what people sell, will be a natural fit to whatever you are doing. The trouble with this evolutionary approach is that it doesn't really address what you need to try to do to make it more likely that your company is a natural fit. And that's why clever strategy is somewhere between the extremes. It does try to plan deliberate actions to shape the future, but also tries to stay close to local events and to react to them. In this way, strategy is transformed into a learning process that becomes, at its best, smarter through experimentation. Success. Progress is made when the organization moves towards strategy that learns its lessons and adapts to new opportunities. In this way, you can benefit from strategic thinking that is clever rather than a one-size-fits-all strategy. You will also see people at all levels more involved because managers are interested in what is really happening at the front line. Your strategy efforts will use strategic principles and tools to better prepare the organization for shaping the future. Your strategy will craft a response to external waves, needs of customers, and actions of competitors. Your strategy will consider the nature of the business, its purpose, style, and products, and the ways that it organizes internal resources, processes, and people. Strategists' measures of success. Understand and apply the main strategy questions. Use the differences between planning, coping, adapting, and shaping covered throughout this book. Consider a wide range of internal and external aspects. Accept the need to build a strategic organization to achieve shared purpose. Establish a flexible, continuous approach to strategy. Pitfalls. It's important that efforts to introduce more strategy don't lead to less strategic thinking or worse results. There are lots of naturally strategic people who see opportunities, see new patterns, and adjust the work of the organization to take advantage of these. It's also important not to simply replace one set of words with another. The idea of strategic thinking is to improve results. Strategists' checklist. Remember that inward-looking planning is not sufficient because of the high levels of external change and competition. Work your way through the strategy questions and answer them for your business. This provides a valuable template for developing creative strategy that is straightforward enough for all sizes of business. Understand the importance of a learning approach to strategy. This means that as many people as possible are engaged with strategy so that they can adapt what they do to support the purpose of the organization and so that they can feed back valuable information to their leadership team in order to adapt the official strategy. Related ideas. For Professors Howard Thomas and Tayyib Hafsi, strategy is a mixture of rules of thumb and creative methods. It helps people understand and transform reality. This means that strategy tools are only viable if they stay close to reality. Some techniques are useful only for making specific decisions. The most powerful tools will help people navigate the process of shaping the future. Without this, strategy is nothing. It's worth remembering that the actions of people in organizations can be the result of habits, hypothesis, or heuristics. Any of these actions can have strategic consequences. This is particularly true for deep patterns of actions that shape what and how an organization behaves. As an example, research by Bingham and Eisenhardt, professors at North Carolina and Stanford, introduces the idea that organizations develop a portfolio of heuristics. These are lessons, helpful and unhelpful, that come from experience that shape actions. Some of these lessons become an embedded and unquestioned part of culture. Hypothesis can help challenge both habits and heuristics where necessary. For similar reasons, Richard Rumelt argues in his best-selling book, Good Strategy, Bad Strategy, that the key is to have a diagnosis and guiding policy connected to a set of coherent, real-world actions. He concludes that bad strategy is fluff, while good strategy is logic, although you should note that smart strategy is often ultimately a form of fuzzy logic that must adapt to messy, real-world situations. Thinking before you plan. Strategy is about outthinking your competition. It's about vision first and planning second. That's why it's so important that you think before you plan, and that the thinking part of what you do is given priority. Strategists who don't take time to think are just planners. Frequency. Before, during, and after planning. Key participants. Everyone needs to think, but this starts with you. Mark Zuckerberg, while at Harvard, built a website called FaceMash for fun. He built it over the weekend. He built it without permission. It was a copy of an already existing idea, and it was shut down. So he decided to build something better and launched Facebook from his dorm room. Thinking came first. What stuff could be done and why? Then the planning. Even today, Facebook believes that done is better than perfect. And that's how creative strategic thinking works best. Done strategically is often better than operationally perfect. Zuckerberg continues to educate analysts about the long-term thinking that guides Facebook's actions. In this way, he gains long-term supporters who have done their own thinking before investment. Buying Instagram for $1 billion over one Easter weekend, or WhatsApp for $21 billion, happened not because it was planned, but because Facebook had already done so much strategic thinking. This strategic philosophy is about outthinking criticism, however merited, and competition from new entrants, like TikTok or WeChat, to keep growing profit. It's a think first, plan later approach. Objective. Planning takes time. It's serious work and it's relatively unimaginative and uninspiring. It has to be that way because planning is about getting things done. It's a practical part of organizing effort. Tasks are listed, project teams formed, and complex projects, charts, and checklists are created. But if you start the planning before thinking, you can end up with the wrong solution to the right problem, or perhaps the right solution to the wrong problem, or the least imaginative solution to a really important problem. You might miss out on all of the creative ways you could have grabbed the very biggest opportunities. Your objective should be to make sure that imaginative, open, playful, passionate thinking happens before the serious work of planning begins. That's what strategy is about. Thinking strategically. Your objective should be to stay as open as possible before you get down to the realistic business of planning. You'll find that it's just as easy to plan something amazing as it is to plan something obvious. Context. Strategy is about the shortest route between means and ends. It's either about outthinking the competition, or even better, about finding new, even greater opportunities. Opportunities the competition hasn't found yet, or opportunities the competition doesn't understand because it hasn't done the kind of thinking that you have. There are always better ways of doing anything. There are always shorter routes for getting from where you are to where you want to be. There are always new markets that are growing faster than your market. There are forever methods, relationships, and ideas just waiting to be discovered. And these can only be discovered by creating room slack for thinking. Throughout the strategy book, there are questions you should be thinking about. There are thought experiments to be done alone and also in groups. You don't need to try out every plan in practice. You need to test a range of plans in your mind. You need to explore what is possible so you can extend what is possible. That is the essential value of strategic thinking against just working hard. It requires you to question what is being done and what could be done. Challenge. There are lots of reasons why organizations don't think before they plan. The most important given is probably the lack of time. People say they are so busy planning, organizing, doing and coping with problems that they don't have time for thinking. Thinking is a luxury they wish they had time for, but don't. Some people think thinking is an unnecessary luxury. For action-orientated individuals, it may seem obvious what they should be doing. The more pressing questions are how efficiently they can organize the work and how effectively they can get people to do the work. Experience with ineffective bureaucracy can also reduce people's patience with attempts at spending time thinking. Painful brainstorming, meetings from hell, and hierarchies replete with steering committees make everything to do with strategy unattractive to those who want to get things done. Successful organizations try to have a healthy balance between thinking, planning, and doing. They spend time learning from what they have done before and how well their plans have led to the results that they intended. They also just explore their world without specific plans in mind. It's worth asking a few questions. How much time have you invested in thinking about strategy? How many options have you considered before the plan was written? How have you ensured that the thinking behind the plan is challenged? How much time do you spend exploring trends, possibilities, and cool stuff? How much time is spent playing with ideas, hopes, and dreams? Success. You'll know that you're getting better at thinking before planning when there is time for thinking built into your corporate calendar and, just as importantly, into your personal timetable. It doesn't need to be excessive. The idea is to find an effective balance, but that means more than a couple of days a year. Thinking about strategy is not just for the people who like to think about strategy. So success will also be measured by the range of people you involve in the thinking and questioning that come before strategy. Is the whole team taking an effective part in thinking sessions? Are the different departments and functions included? Is the complete organization included in the thinking process? Are people outside the organization and customers included? Asking demanding questions about the plans, results, and thinking of the past will become an acceptable, even necessary, part of how the organization works. More importantly, time spent creatively exploring possibilities and opportunities will be viewed as viable activity. Challenging pervading wisdom will be given the room it deserves, and those who ask difficult questions will be protected. Strategists, measures of success. You understand the thinking that got your company to where it is now. Thinking is built into your strategy and planning process. Different thought experiments happen before planning and action. You recognize the value of thinking as a distinct part of strategic success. Your company knows how to challenge its own thinking and actions. You stay with problems and opportunities long enough to make progress. Pitfalls. Telling people to think before they plan can lead to problems. Some may conclude that you're trying to slow down meaningful action. One risk is that urgency is reduced by those who don't want to move to action. Another is that those who want action fight against the thinking because they believe it's wasted time. It's important to clarify the benefits of thinking before planning and to build it into specific stages of the strategy through to the action process. Strategists, checklist. Remember that the best strategy is about thinking your way to new possibilities from where you are currently. Planning comes next. Improving strategy means improving your ability to think, not just your intelligence or your knowledge, but the ways in which you think. Establish time for thinking in your schedule and include time for thinking in the normal schedule for your team, department, or organization, particularly before the start of new planning efforts. Avoid having just one plan or set of options to follow. Try several different courses of action. Experiment with them using imagination to see what advantages each route forward offers. Bring in external people to challenge and examine your thinking. It's important that they don't just agree with whatever you have planned.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.